What's up guys, so GeoGebra is here. So in this video, we're going to investigate the relationship between two triangles. And in doing so, we will be learning the rotate about point tool or the rotate around point tool. So this is the focus tool in this video. To start off, we have to draw a segment using the segment tool. And to do that, we select the segment tool from the toolbar and then click on two different locations on the graphics view. And then we draw a point on the segment. So we use the point tool and then be sure to click on the segment. Be sure that even if you drag C outside the line segment, C should still be on the segment. Next, we draw two equilateral triangles with sides AC and CB. To do that, we use the regular polygon tool. So select the polygon tool from the toolbar, click on A, and then click on C. And then in the regular polygon vertices text box, type 3. Meaning it's an equilateral triangle. Next, create another equilateral triangle by clicking on C and then on B. And there are our triangles. All right, so we won't be needing the polygon. We just need the vertices and we connect the vertices using the segment tool. Now notice what happens if I move point C here. So even if I move C, the two triangles are always equilateral. Next, I connect points A and E with a segment, and then points D and B with another segment. Again, notice what happens if I move C. Now, what we are going to investigate is the relationship between this triangle, ACE, and triangle DB, or DCB, or DCB. So, can you make a conjecture just by looking? Okay. So I think you notice that it seems the two triangles are congruent. And to use GeoGebra to investigate their congruence, what we can do is we can draw triangle ACE and rotate it about point C so that it fits perfectly with triangle DCB. Okay. So meaning this, I'll rotate AC about point C and A will go to D, which means that I will be rotating this side by 60 degrees clockwise. That means that I have to create a slider, an angle slider, with a maximum measure of 60 degrees. Okay. And then I will rotate this polygon about C alpha degrees counterclockwise. So to do that, I'll click on the rotate around point tool, click on the object that I want to rotate, this time the polygon, click on the point of rotation, center of rotation, that's C, and then change the angle to alpha, which is my slider here, and then select clockwise. Right. So there's my triangle. Okay, so it looks like the two triangles are congruent. To finalize the construction, we hide the points and the original polygon by right clicking each of them and selecting show object. This one also, we will hide C prime and see what happens. So it's exact, it looks like it's congruent. Now what happens if I move C? Is it still congruent? Yes. Okay, so that's it. That's it for this tutorial. In doing this tutorial, you have learned how to use the segment tool, the regular polygon tool, the polygon tool, and the focus tool for this tutorial is the rotate around point tool. Of course, you have also learned how to use the slider tool, which you have learned many times in previous tutorials. I hope you have learned from this tutorial. Please subscribe to my channel and invite your friends. Comment if you like, and don't forget the thumbs up. Thank you.